So the X275 category is defined by several things. The first being cars that look like cars. The second being a very varied but tight set of rules. And the third, the fact that it's all built around a 275 millimeter wide rear tire. Most of the cars in this category run the Mickey Thompson tires, if not all of them. And they are powered by engines that range from Cummins diesels to turbocharged small blocks and nitrous injected big blocks. Elapsed times, solid ones, record setting ones are down in the 430s. And a lot of cars live in that 440 and 450 zone.
one of Duck's races is the ultimate win. I've dreamt about it, worked hard for it, done everything we could to the car, and finally put a race together and ended up winning. It's an unbelievable feeling. I can't describe it. Just overwhelmed with emotion to shut down. Crying and laughing, needed a steering wheel, bent mine all up, celebrating. It's hard to describe. Just happy.
At what point did you think this race was yours to win?
Well, I never did. You have to take it round by round, set the car up for the conditions. Don't worry about the competition. You just race your own race. I never once thought I had the car to win or had it won at all. I knew we had a car that could win. I got one whole shot. We got lucky in the last round and Shane had trouble. I think he might have had us otherwise. Car stumbled a little bit out of the hole and we didn't run quite what we wanted to, but it was enough to win. So, luck and good calls, that's what it takes to get to the winner's circle in these races. It's so tight. So tight. I don't know exactly what we were all separated by, but the last eight cars were probably hundreds. Just it's so tight. Great competition. All the guys here is awesome.